And talking about the battleground in America, what are things looking like ahead of the November election? Let me tell you this, there is a lot of speculation. Also, as far as data from the election betting market goes, it seems Kamala Harris is closing the gap to Donald Trump following Joe Biden's withdrawal from the 2024 U.S. presidential race and the growing support for Kamala Harris since then. Data from gambling companies depict Harris's chances are gradually improving. On Saturday, a day before Biden announced that he is no longer running for a possible second term, Trump's chances of winning stood at 64%, Harris 17%, and Biden 7%. As per British gambling company Betfair Exchange, following the 2024 Republican National Convention, just days after the assassination attempt on Donald Trump, Trump's chances of winning stood at 69%, and this fell to 62% on Sunday following the announcement of Biden dropping out of the race. And in contrast, the chances of winning for Kamala Harris have gradually risen following the endorsement by Joe Biden. It stood at 23%, and as more and more Democrats are publicly backing her, it has gone to 29%. And that, by the way, is the highest percentage that Harris has received on the Betfair, although much lower than Donald Trump, who has a winning percentage at 62%. A similar trend can be seen on American prediction market company Polymarket. According to its data, Trump's lead has come down over the past week, dropping by 6 points from 71% to 65%. And in the same period, Harris, who had a single-digit win percentage, has risen to 32%. New Zealand-based online prediction market Predict It is also reflecting a similar shift regarding Donald Trump. From a winning percentage of 69%, Trump has gone down to 60% in a matter of 1 week. Meanwhile, Harris has a 39% chance of winning the election. As Harris's chances of winning see a surge, Democrats are breathing a sigh of relief. With Biden out, reports suggesting that many Democrats believe they have a fighting chance. A majority of Democratic voters felt that Biden was too old to run. His performance in the first debate against Trump last month, where he was often seen fumbling and being incoherent, or the subsequent gaffes, like introducing Ukraine's President Volodymyr Zelensky on stage as the Russian President Vladimir Putin, or calling Donald Trump as the Vice President of the United States, all of this did little to allay fears and the concerns. And the concerns about Biden's cognitive abilities became an international topic. That also became too much for the Democratic leaders to ignore, with many publicly calling on Biden to end his presidential campaign. So Biden's decision, at the minimum, has come as a respite, one that many Democratic supporters reckon can rekindle the party's fight against the Republicans. And while referring to Kamala Harris, Democrat politician from Texas, James Tallarico, told a digital news website that the Democratic Party has presented a young, energetic leader who can prosecute the case against Trump. Similarly, Democratic Party member Mallory McMorrow from Michigan also reportedly said that Kamala Harris can ignite the energy the party needs to ensure Donald Trump remains a one-term president. And as we wait for an official confirmation on the presidential candidate from the Democratic Party, one thing is clear, that bookmakers and Democrat faithfuls are pinning their hopes for a closer fight from Harris. To stay up to speed with the latest news, download the WION app and subscribe to our YouTube channel.